Hi there, everybody. Martin Tyler here, along with the former Arsenal and England striker, Alan Smith.
Yeah, you come into ground some days and you do get that buzz of excitement, and I've got it here today, Martin. Looking forward to it.
The game today, Tottenham against Crystal Palace.
This home side, I think, will be full of confidence, rightfully going for a Champions Cup place. It's a wonderful opportunity here to show the fans exactly what they're capable of. Coming up against a side that, middle of the road in many respects, can't see them doing too much in terms of pushing up in the table, but they're not going to get relegated, mid-table side all over.
Crystal Palace, they'll want to show themselves in a better light today than that home reverse in their last match against West Bromwich Albion.
Yeah, they didn't play well in that 1-0 defeat, and do you know what? Nothing to suggest that they're going to do any better. I think they'll lose.
This is today's Tottenham Hotspur team. Michel Vorm plays in goal. Danny Rose starts with Kyle Walker in the fullback positions, and they just go with the one striker up front. I know it's hard for you to talk about White Hart Lane as an Arsenal legend, Alan, but did you enjoy playing here?
Well, when we won, I did, and we won a few times. But you knew you were in enemy territory from the moment you pulled up to the stadium, on the way to the ground, actually. It was great because special games, the North London derbies, and we all used to love playing at this place.
We've got some news coming up from Turf Moor, from Alan McAnally.
It's a goal for Burnley. 5 minutes played, 1-0.
Thank you very much, Alan. Well, they're in a good position here. It's a turnover of possession here. Son. Here's Ali, trying to switch on the referee, giving the player the benefit of the doubt about that, but he's given the free kick. Some transfer news for you to digest, Alan Smith, for all of us to digest, really. Gonzalo Higuain has moved to Juventus.
Exciting deal, this, for the fans and for his teammates. Around £70 million, money well spent, I think.
That's going to be a goal kick. Here's Ali. It's looking good, this move. Kyle Walker. Well, that's always the goalkeeper's ball, and a simple catch, as much as anything is simple in this game. Trying to stretch the opposition, using the wider areas here. They've coped with it well defensively. Good position. They've worked this attack very well into a quite a dangerous position now. Sissoko. Victor Wanyama. Musa Sissoko. There goes the cross. He's better usually at crossing than that. It was a defence. It's a free kick given against Tottenham. Patrick Van Aanholt. It is an advantage for Crystal Palace, and they're going to try and take advantage of the referee's decision. Victor Wanyama. They tried to keep it, but they haven't been able to do that. Short passes, but they're keeping the ball. Defender to it first. That attack was looking good. Now the opposition have a chance. Well, that looked promising, but he's been stopped. It's a poor touch, and the possession's gone away. Well, this attack got a bit of menace to it. And in goes the cross. James McArthur. Now it's a free kick that the referee has decided to award. Could be dangerous. Really trying to use the full width of the pitch here to make some progress. And the cross coming in. Trying to cross it, and in the end, a bit of a waste, I think. Townsend. And in he goes with the tackle. Danny Rose. Still chance for something to happen because there's three added minutes.
3 minutes added time.
Here's Ali. Well, they're building steadily here, working away. Song. Played into the middle. They put that cross far too close to the goalkeeper. Well, that is half time, and the score is 0-0 here. The two teams here have got a lot of potential to play better than this.
Yeah, they're trying to find highlights on the...
And now we're going to have an alteration. Start of the second half for you. James McArthur. There's good progress with this attack. They've coped with it well defensively. Well, now they've won the ball back in the middle of the park by intercepting that pass. Up at Turf Moor, there's been a goal, Alan McAnally.
It's the second goal for Burnley. 52 minutes, please.
Gonna try his luck. Chance taken, goal, they're in front.
And the keeper's got no chance because he's hit it so hard to his right.
Another angle on it here. So, finally, the stalemate is broken here, and we have a goal. Here's Ali. Brilliant football from this team. Defensive block there, no cross coming in, cut out by the defender, gets his foot in there, really strong tackle, and the ball's gone out for a throw. At the Liberty Stadium, Alan McAnally has got some news for us.
It's a goal for Hull City. It's been scored by Tom Huddleston. He nutmegged the first defender, went past the second and shot past the keeper in a lovely solo display. 61 minutes played, 1-1.
Well, many thanks, Alan McAnally, keeping us up to date as usual. Johan Kabay, he's coming forward with some danger. Good through pass. Substitute ready for Tottenham Hotspur. Eric Lamella.
Well, they gave it straight to him, didn't they?
James McArthur. Made the challenge well. Sizoka. Still 20 minutes to go. Trying to find a way through here. Probing away. Onto the attack now. Trying to thread it through here. Defender to it first. Going for goal! That's well wide. And the referee apparently at Swansea has given a penalty at the Liberty Stadium, Alan McInally.
It's a penalty for Swansea City. He's put the ball down on the spot. Here he comes. Strike.
Power to the goalkeeper's left. Absolutely no chance. Great goal.
75 minutes played. 2-1.
Thank you very much, Alan. And the assistant signals for the throw. Well, we're in the last knockings of the game, but we're still on the edge of our seats here. It's that close. It's looking good, this move. They've coped with it well defensively. Well, that'll be a throw. Andros Townsend. Defender to it first. Now it's offside, and it looks as though they might be in to score. Seven more minutes to go. Moving forward with some danger to the opposition now they're here. Good defending. Joel Ward. Well, that's not so much an interception as a poor pass. Dembele. Andros Townsend.
The fourth official crowd, is indicated.
Maybe expected a bit more, but two added minutes. And that's the end of the game, and it's 1-0. Well, you don't have to dominate a game to win it. This game is proof of that.
You certainly don't, and the little scoreline in the top corner of the screen is what matters more than possession.
Burnley 2, Liverpool 1. Leicester City 1, Arsenal 1. Stoke City 0, Manchester City 2. Swansea City 2, Hull City 1. Tottenham Hotspur 0, Crystal Palace 1. Watford 1, Chelsea 0. West Bromwich Albion 1, Everton 0.
Martin Tyler here with Alan Smith. Hello to you all and welcome to today's game. Coming up now, Crystal Palace, and they play Bournemouth. Well, the Eagles of Crystal Palace, will they be flying high, do you think, Alan Smith?
Not a bad start for this side that could probably finish mid-table. I think already in that win and that defeat, they've shown their good and their bad traits. And I think there's something here, though. They'll be feeling pretty confident.
It's a debut for the new forward today.
Yeah, and with that comes a little bit of pressure because everyone's expecting you to score the goals. The fans are, I think.
Crystal Palace, a good side they look at the moment. They won away their last game against Tottenham Hotspur.
They'd finished 1-0. It was quite a close run affair. But I think they are capable of following up with another win today.
Here's the Crystal Palace team. Steve Mandanda starts in goal. Nathan Ake starts. Oh, he's through. James McArthur. Well, he's threaded the path through neatly. I love to see that, the referee. Well, it's a pretty robust start to the game. It's certainly a foul, but the referee's kept his cards in his pocket. On to the attack now. Trying to find a way through here, probing away. Not a great cross at all in the circumstances. And pretty easy to cope with by the defending team. Corner goes straight to the opposition. It's looking good, this move. Now they've got the ball back. What can they do from here? Good play, but they've lost the ball now, and the opposition can get at them. Goal news from Watford.
It's a goal for Watford. It's been scored by Mbaye Niang. He showed great calmness and composure to tuck away the chance when the move seemed to have broken down on the edge of the area. 70 minutes played, 1-0.
Thank you very much, Alan. Well, he could go for goal from here. We've got a situation here, Alan, where the home team are happy with the draw. The away fans getting a bit restless now, aren't they? They think there's a bit of time wasting going on here.
Well, I think that
tries to punch it away. Tries the through pass. Neither side able to dwell on the ball for very long here. Attacking now. Room for the cross, and he's headed it goalwards. Great stop, and that will be a corner. It will be their throw. Well, I guess, and the referee says free kick. Johan Kabay. Stopping the pass getting through with a good piece of anticipation. Goalkeeper can get the ball here for his goal kick. Patrick Van Aanholt. They can unhinge the opposition here because they're players you don't really expect to be up on the attack all the time.
They're so adventurous, aren't they? And they're taking one or two chances, leaving one or two gaps at the back.
Let's go over to Stamford Bridge and Alan McInally.
It's a second goal for Chelsea. 36 minutes played. 2-0.
Thanks, Alan. Chance for back-to-back wins for the new manager, having been successful in his second game in charge. Here's game number three, and beginning to take shape under him.
I think so. I mean, there were signs that he's getting the players on side, and another win here, the crowd will be right behind him.
This is an exercise in patience as they shots on here, and he's taken the chance beautifully. What a moment for him on his debut for his new club. It's a super goal.
Well, it's the perfect start, isn't it? And that'll give him so much confidence for the weeks ahead. And what a finish from him, from miles out. And he's just stroked it home. That takes real technique.
Well, that could change things. The goal that we felt we needed has come along.
It's been a bit dull, it's been a bit dire at times. Goals do change matches. Let's hope for everybody's sake that's the case here.
Jack Wilshere onto the attack now.
The referee has indicated
doing well to keep the ball.
Will be a minimum of 4 minutes of added time.
They've coped with it well defensively. That's cut out. Cross coming in now. Trying to cross it, and in the end, a bit of a waste, I think. Makes a challenge here. Keeps it going. And it's a shot now! Goodness me, it's hit the post. And that's half-time. Signaled by the referee. 1-0 the half-time. Well, there's still time to hit back in this game, and they're going to try and do it with a substitute.
Coming onto the pitch, number four, Dan Gosling.
It is the kickoff here for the second half. Francis. Now it goes into the wider areas where they've got a winger waiting. Building steadily here, keeping possession. Tight against the touchline, and pretty clear that it was going to end up with a throw-in. Attacking well here. Oh, good through ball. Max Gradel. It's a good piece of defending to stop the supply into the centre. Referee has pointed for a corner.
Well, it's a side foot from an awfully long way out, but he did get a fair bit of power in placing it to the right.
Looking for an opening with some good controlled build-up. Max Gradel. We've got the away manager indicating he wants to make a substitution now. And that passing is top class. Tackle goes in. James MacArthur. What a good piece of defensive clearance that was. James MacArthur. Tabai. Trying to find an opening. Not panicking. And the cross coming in. Opportunity now. Very good stop here. That would be a throw.
Substitution for Bournemouth coming off the pitch.
Well, a real treat in store for you. Coverage on EA Sports of the Premier League fixture. Crystal Palace, they'll be facing Middlesbrough.
Yeah, really looking forward to this one. I think we're going to see some good football.
There's going to be a substitution. It's for the away team. And here's the shot. Goalkeeper hangs on. Made the challenge well. Tabai. And he could get away here. Well, just a chance to tell you about a confirmed transfer here. Mats Hummels has joined Bayern Munich.
Yeah, well, they've had to put the money in the pockets. About 50 million quid, which... I don't think that's an outrageous figure for somebody of his quality.
Andros Townsend. Cross coming in now. Well, they got it wide very well. The chance to get the cross in, but it's not turned out to be a very good delivery. Smith. And it's going to be his throw here. And he goes for goal with his head. Well, that was an opportunity for him to score again. And well played by the goalkeeper, who this time got the better of him.
Yeah, good use of the legs, and his positioning really did narrow down the angle.
And we have 9 remaining minutes. Let's go over to Stamford Bridge and Alan McInally.
It's a third goal for Chelsea. It's been scored by Eden Hazard. An angled cross was flighted into the box and he was on hand.
Instant judgment and movement by the goalkeeper.
Well, his starting position was very good and he showed a nice bit of pace to get out there.
Offside, that's an easy decision. Well, now they've won the ball back in the middle of the park by intercepting that pass. Right from the beginning, we've never known which way this game is going to go, and it's kept its drama right to the last. Jack Wilshere, well, we're down to the last minute here. 3 minutes to be added on. Intercepted well. He's coming forward with some danger. That's great defending there, stopping that attack. And that's the end of the game, and it's 1-0. Well, you don't have to dominate.
Chelsea 3, Burnley 0. Crystal Palace 1, Bournemouth 0. Everton 0, Stoke City 2. Hull City 1, Manchester United 3. Leicester City 3, Swansea City 1. Tottenham Hotspur 2, Liverpool 0. Watford 1, Arsenal 0. Now let's see what effect that's had on the league standings. At the top of the table, we have new leaders in Manchester United with 6 points. In second, Chelsea with 6 points. In third, with 6 points.